Welcome to the Vue Range Slider tutorial. The Syncfusion Vue Range Slider is utilized to select a single value or a range of values. The control has major tweaks, minor tweaks, a thumb, and a tooltip that can be fully customized. In this video, you will see how to add the Range Slider component to a Vue application with a few of its basic features like types, ticks, tooltip, format, and limits. I will also explain how to customize the range slider using CSS classes. I will start with the application creation process. I'm going to create a Vue application using the Vue Vite command. Make sure you have installed the latest version of Vue and Node.js. To create a project in Vue, I open Visual Studio Code and type the command npm create vite at latest. I provide the app name, my Vue app. Next, I choose Vue as the framework and JavaScript as the variant. The Vue project has been created. I navigate to the newly created Vue app and install the required dependencies using the npm install command. Now the application is configured with the default settings of a Vue project. To add the Syncfusion Vue Range Slider component, I install the Syncfusion Vue Inputs package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vueinputs --save. This command will install the inputs package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, the application is ready to use. The first thing I must do here is register the trial license key to use the Syncfusion components. I open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To see how to generate the license key, refer to the link in the description below. The application is now configured to use Syncfusion Vue components. To start using the Vue Range slider, I open the App Vue page and remove the default code snippets. I import the slider component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Inputs package. To add CSS reference for the Vue Range slider component, I import the necessary CSS references. I have also added dependent CSS references like buttons and pop-ups. Next, I add the slider component by adding EJ's slider tag. To render the slider, I need to set a custom slider value using the value property. I define a variable value and set its value to 30. Then I assign this variable to the value property of the slider. Now save the changes and run the application using the npm run dev command. Check now, the range slider is rendered with the value 30. You can choose any desired value. This is the default slider type for selecting a single value. The other slider types are minRange and range. To render a minRange slider, I define a variable type and set the value as minRange. Then I assign this variable to the type property of the slider. See, the slider displays a shadow from the start value to the current selected value. To select a range of values, change the slider type to range. I need to provide a range of values to the value property. Let me set 30 as the starting and 70 as the ending values. Checking now, the specified range is selected in the slider. Next, I will show you how to display a tooltip in the slider. I define an object, tooltip, and within it, I set the isVisible property to true. I then assign this object to the tooltip property of the slider. See now, the tooltip is shown when I click the slider bar or drag the handle. To always show the tooltip, set the showOn property to always. Check now, the tooltip is always shown. Notice that the tooltip is shown above the slider bar. To change this position, set the placement property to after. Now the tooltip displays below the slider bar. By default, the slider value can be changed using the slider handler. I can also change the value using buttons. To demonstrate, I define a variable named showButtons and set its value to true. I then assign this variable to the showButtons property of the slider. See here, the slider has been rendered with buttons, and I can increase or decrease the values using them. Next, I will show you how to enable ticks in a slider. I define an object named ticks, and within it I set the small step property to 10 and the large step property to 20. The small step property is used to denote the distance between two minor ticks from the scale of the slider, and the large step property is used to denote the distance between two major ticks. I can also set the placement property to after to indicate the position of the ticks in the slider. Then set the showSmallTicks property to true to show the small ticks. I then assign this object to the ticks property of the slider. Look, the slider renders with ticks and labels. The slider displays only the large ticks by default. Notice the slider displays the unit values in numbers. If you want to display it in a desired format, use the format property. To visualize ticks in kilometers, set the format property to kilometers like this. Here, hash represents the unit value of the slider. See now, the ticks are displayed in kilometers. You can restrict the dragging of the slider to a certain range. 7 built-in options are available to limit the slider thumb between a particular range. They are enabled, min start, min end, max start, max end, start handle fixed, and end handle fixed. Here, I will demonstrate a few options. I define an object named limits, and within it, I set the enabled property to true. I set the min start property to 10 to set the minimum limit of the first handle. Then set the min end property to 30 to set the maximum limit. Similarly, set the minimum and maximum limits of the second handle. I then assign this object to the limits property of the slider. Checking the slider now, I can drag the first handle between 10 and 30 units, and the second handle between 40 and 60 units. Finally, I will show you how to add custom styles to the slider. In the style tag, define the eControl wrapper, eSlider container, eSlider, and eHandle CSS classes for the slider handle, and add the custom background color and border. See, the slider is customized. Similarly, you can customize tracks, limits, and buttons using the appropriate CSS classes. In this video, I've shown you how to add the range slider component to a Vue application. I also showed you a few basic features like types, ticks, tooltip, format, limits, and how to customize the range slider using CSS classes. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link where you can learn about obtaining a free license key to use our Vue suite if you are eligible for our community license. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.